taking white and now I am going to put my brush here and take it up like this. My brush, I will now load my brush with red color. Put it here and bring it down till here. Okay, put it here and bring it down till here. I'm painting carnations and I'm using a smaller flat brush. I'm bringing my edges down like this. This time I'll take red, put my brush with red and red. To give a little depth to the center, I'm taking a little bit of Prussian blue. I'm going to add it here. This portion I'm adding a little bit of Prussian blue and I'm going to cover this up. With red, you take red and dab it on top of this. For this petal, I'll take white and I'll wiggle like this. Here, I'm going to wiggle. It till here. This is all wiggle. I'm just trying to now I'll take red, put it here on the center like this and take it up. Which brush I had blue, I'm going to do it here so that my center portion of the flower remains stuck. When I finish this flower, come back to this portion again. Now in blush Prussian blue, I'm going to mix a little red for the dark areas. For different colors, I'm using different brushes. Now here, I'm going to do this petal. For different petals, I'm using different brushes. For different colors, I'm using different brushes. Now here is one petal. It's a red color. It's red like this. I have loaded the brush with two colors. One side is white, the other side is red. Now I am going to put my brush like this. I am going to do it like this. This is red in which I have mixed a little blue. And then now this is the darkest portion of the flower. So I am using over here Prussian blue and red. So I'm going to mix that here and just trying to like it. This is the center portion. Constantly my brushes are changing. This is the center portion of the flower. So the red I've just mixed a little right here. Again I need red here dark red. I'm using Fevicryl red. The red which is available, Fevicryl, I'm using that. Now I need a little variations in the petal. Otherwise all my petals will look the same. So whenever you are drawing and you have to just simply get up, stand up from your place and look at your drawing if it is looking correct or not. If from a distance you can see the depth or not of the flower. Because if you cannot find the dark portions, differentiate the dark from the light, then it's no use. When you finish, your flower won't look nice. So it's very important that you keep checking yourself that whatever you are doing. You find it correct or not. To slip tree, simply stand up and see which side my flower is bending, leaves are bending side or not. I have loaded my brush with two colors, red and white. Loaded my brush with two colors, red and white. Now I am going to put my brush in such a way that red is on top and white, and I'm going to wiggle, 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 wiggle. Now this, after doing this, I have to add a little depth to my flower. So what do? Just take the mixture which I had formed of blue and red, and I am going to take it inside like this. Over here, loaded my brush with two colors and red from here. Just have to pinpoint your brush so that your color is this side. I have turned my brush like this, and now the dark color I'm just applying mixture of blue and this thing I'm putting this side. This here. This has spoiled the effect. I need to have a little, I'll let it dry up. Come back to this petal afterwards. Like two colors, load your brush with two colors. Now, put your brush in such a way that your red is inside and your more white is needed here. Yeah. Just add a dab of white here, yeah. Here also, and here. Again, I will load my brush. My brush again straight. Bring it back here. Bring it back here. Again. Take it back. Now again, I need a little white. Okay, now this brush is too thick for this part. So what I'll do, I'll just take another brush and do this portion. This needs to be done. My brush again straight. Bring it back here. Bring it back here again. Take it back. Now again, I need a little white. Okay. Now this brush is too thick for this part. So what I'll do, I'll just take another brush. This needs to be done. This is pure red here. This I have to do with this portion. I have to show, so I am doing a little dark color here. Dark color means red mixed with blue. This is the shadow of the petal which is falling there. Now again, load your brush again with white and red, put it straight here. Bring it down like this. You have to bring it down. This petal, I feel, should be till here. So I'm just increasing the size of this petal. So because I feel this should be till here. So just, and this goes up. Just I'll take pure red and take the petal up like this. Little seen flowers. It's very easy. If you find something you don't think it is correct, you just come back to it and do it afterwards. Is not feeling this is correct. I am Prussian blue, mixing red with little Prussian blue. This side also here, a little light pink should be done. Light pink mixed with little white. I will put my brush and take it down like this and leave it here. This red also. This is the petal is going up. So you have to show the direction it's moving. Like this. See? You have to take your hand up and leave it. And here also. Goes like this. Take a little red and put it here and bring it. Take red, take white, put your brush here. You really need a thick brush for painting carnations. You really need to have a thick brush. Let it dry up, otherwise this is becoming dark. I don't want my color to spoil. So this is becoming dark. I'm not going to use this color here. Now what I'll do is I'll just take this up like this. Oh, has become so dark. I didn't realize this was so dark. So I'll take dab red and a little white. Just going to Carnation, there are so many petals. You really can't differentiate. Now here, I've done this petal here. I need to do this petal also. Now this petal is left here, which is half up and half down. This one. Now again, I'm putting my brush here. I'm taking it. I'll use another brush and this I'm going to this petal. Half up and half down. Just taking a little red and dabbing it here. Take white in your brush, put it here, take it like this. Take white and take your brush like this. Now again load my brush with red. We're just coming to the end of the flower, but I have to highlight the dark portions just still left. The shadows I have to highlight. Shadow areas. Just trying to highlight just highlighting the shadow areas wherever the petals ending and where the other one is starting, just trying to highlight those areas. So this petal is coming down from here. It is coming down. These are the areas where petals are. This one is going up. In carnation there are so many petals, so it's difficult to find out where one is ending and the other is starting. But still, the movement of the brush is very important. These are petals all there. Yeah. best is done through a thick brush, where you just load your brush with the paint, your brush here, and you just move your brush. So you just like this, when you're moving the brush, automatically the shading is done. You really don't need to have, you really don't need to bother, like, see, where's the white? So just keep my white here. Just like this. The white is now becoming pink. Think I've done, finished. All the color has dried. I hardly have any color to fill in the gaps. Take out more color then.